under the patronage of Lieutenant General Sheikh Saif bin Zayed Al Nahyan, UAE Minister of Interior and Deputy Prime Minister. The General Headquarters of Civil Defense presents the 5th Annual Fire Safety Technology Forum, UAE.
Ladies and gentlemen, estimated participants of today's event. My name is Robert Kopp. I am the Deputy Police Commissioner of the Police Headquarters Munich, a police agency in southern Germany with about 7,000 staff. In this function, I am also responsible for preparing and carrying out police operations. It's my pleasure to take part in your conference to present to you the task of the Police Headquarters Munich in dealing with police missions during major events. In the first part of my speech, I will go into the current development of events taking place in Munich. In the second part, I will talk about the necessary measures in the run-up to major events, considering their special risk and dangers, and in particular, explain the so-called security concept. The last part of the presentation will involve police tasks and measures. For my explanations, I will mainly use examples and impressions from the operations in Munich. The cooperation with other authorities and organizations dealing with public safety plays a prominent role regarding this subject. As for me, the biggest challenge and the most important task, and this goes for police action too, is to prevent such emergency situations that often end tragically already from happening by talking through it preventive measures. In 2014, about 6,300 events accompanied by the police took place in the area of responsibility of the police headquarters Munich. While on reason for the continuous increase is the high number of people moving to our metropolitan area, this also reflects the event culture to today's generations. This curve represents nearly a duplication in the number of events that need to be accompanied by the police since 2004 and cannot be expected to flatten out. This development means we will face major security-related challenges in future too. In order to cope with event-related police missions during 2014, in total, 30,000 officers were on duty for over 200,000 working hours. The number of sporting events have remained on a nearly constant level year after year. In 2014, with 385 events involving football, basketball, motorsports, and company. During these events, close to 20,000 officers were able to guarantee the safety of the more than 3 million visitors. The absolute highlights among our major events are the Munich Oktoberfest, the football matches of FC Bayern Munich and the German national team in the Allianz Arena, as well as the football-related victory celebrations on public viewing events in the inner city. Both the Oktoberfest and our football teams enjoy worldwide popularity and as showpieces attract visitors from all over the world to Munich, who can enjoy their stay in the Bavarian capital without having to worry about their safety. On top of this, the annual Munich Security Conference in the Hotel Bayerischer Hof with high-ranking politicals and public figures constitutes a challenging police mission to cope with. Several hundred participants, including 140 persons at risk making protective measures necessary. We are in Munich nearly 3 weeks ago. Among the participants of this year's Securities Conference, various Vice President Joe Biden and Chancellor Angela Merkel. During the 3 days of the event, more security measures than ever before were required around the venue. The respective hotels and the guests stayed at the entire city area. The police does not only protect the assemblies of opponents in connection with the Munich Security Conference. In the course of the year 2014, the Munich police had to accompany over 1,200 assemblies in the open. Not forgetting the big concert in the Olympic Stadium or open-air events on squares in the inner city of Munich. When we have summer temperatures, several 10,000 visitors regularly come together here to celebrate and to dance. Munich is an important location of technology, and as such, trade fairs of international renown, like, for example, the International Sport Exhibition, the International Motorcycle Exhibition, the International Trade Fair for Construction, Machinery, Baumau, and many more are of special significance. It's the biggest public festival in the world, the Munich Oktoberfest, on the open space Theresienwiese, has a central status among the police missions as a special major event. With up to 7 million visitors each year, only in 16 days, the Oktoberfest time after time poses an outstanding task for the police, as well as the other authorities and organizations dealing with public safety. The high operational burden, especially during the weekends with many visitors, is also reflected in the plane numbers. More than 2,000 operations of the police, over 800 arrests, but also deploying international colleagues paint a clear picture. We lay the foundation for a safe and peaceful Wiesn, as we call the Oktoberfest in Munich, by implementing measures in the run-up of the festival in close cooperation with the Munich Department of Public Order, especially in terms of bans from access to the Oktoberfest and check of the compliance with legal regulations for the protection of minors. Nonetheless, the event requires the full commitment of all security authorities during the Oktoberfest, but also the months-long preparation phase. This is the only way to give locals and guests from all over the world the chance to celebrate safely and to return home safely too. After the experience with the FIFA World Cup 2006 in our own country and the new fan culture developing in Germany after that, we braced ourselves early on for the operation situations that were to be expected during the World Cup 2014 in Brazil. After important matches of the German national team that finished with the desired results of the fans, each time up to 100,000, 150,000 people flocked to Leopoldstraße, one of the main connection roads from the Munich city center to the north. After having watched the games at so-called public viewing events with up to several tens of thousands of guests in front of huge displays on big squares in the beer garden or in empty football stadiums, the fans celebrated and formed motorcades there to enjoy the victory. The Konisch patriotism, a composite of party and patriotism, is a suitable reflection of the zeitgeist of today's event generation. The main priority is enjoying major events collectively, often combined with partly immoderate drinking. The saying, different strokes for different folks, breathes itself, sir. While Southeast European citizens celebrate noisily, fire pyrotechnics and drive with their cars through the city center in motorcades for long hours, honking the horn, in some cases standing on the car top, waving flags and scarves. South Americans in particular move from bar to bar, loudly dancing and playing music. With regards to group, including many people, the high degrees of alcohol consumption often causes unwanted side effects. This often results in physical altercations. During matches of the German side or FC Bayern Munich, the great mass of fans in particular constitutes the biggest threat potential. The single flows of people that use public transport to go to the city center arrive there right after the end of the match and multiply the number of viewers already present many times over. This stretches the public transport to its limits and at the same time causes private traffic in the inner city to come to a halt completely. Dear audience, in my explanations so far, I have already hinted to the disturbance and danger the police, the often authorities and organizations, the organizer and the guests can face during such major events. In the following, I will on the one hand point out those factors inherent in the event as well as external factors that can lead to dangers of disturbances which are the most important for assessment of the situations. Subsequently, I would like to show you possible problem-solving approaches to prevent emergency situations even from developing. I will begin with disturbances coming out of the event set. If you look at them individually, do not pose a threat for many people yet. Nevertheless, it is imaginable that some of the mentioned disturbances add up or even increase exponentially, and then in combination may endanger the health of life of guests and people uninvolved. First, there would be the problem with noise. People could noise and celebrating people even more so, depending on the type of event, during and time, number of participants and the venue. The public viewing events during the FIFA World Cup in Brazil serve as a recent example for this. It became clear very quickly that not everybody was sharing the enthusiasm of the thousands of people who celebrate the success of their teams on public spaces. Often the limits of what is acceptable were surpassed quite soon, as the playing hours often lasted until late at night. Especially during such events lasting over several weeks, the approval authority needs to check issue and also monitor feasible measures for emission control. If necessary, you have to make amendments at short notice too. In some cases, this led to the public viewing events after 10 p.m. getting prohibited by the Department of Public Order of the Bavarian capital, Munich. However, people do not only generate noise. Waste management is another regular nuisance during events, and preventing litter does not only serve visual reasons. Broken glass in particular regularly leads to injuries among participants of events. In the past, especially during carnival events and celebrations of football fans, we had sheer mountains of broken glass in Munich that were the cause for a great number of cuts. The celebrating people are suffered, mainly on their feet. Measures such as charging a deposit on glass vessels or banning them, as well as using plastic dishes, have proven successful for us. For example, as a consequence of banning the supply of glass bottles, the amount of waste generated during the daily celebrations of the FIFA World Cup 2006 decreased from 40 to 15 tons of waste per day. As an obligatory result, the number of insurers sank too. Resolving the even related traffic problems required a particularly close consultation between organizers, authorities, and the police. In general, the organizer can be given the duty of securing the event area and providing parking facilities. The duty of preventing or minimizing traffic obstructions around the event lies with the security authority or the police. During the preparation of a traffic concept, you especially have to take into account the accepted number of participants, insights on their travel routes, the traffic space available, and the reachability of the venue with public transport. Likewise, an office and particularly time public relations work is of special importance here. An essential factor for assessing an event is in terms of security legislation is the expected number of visitors. Thus, you have to factor in all information available while estimating the attendance. This includes advertising for the events. What is advertised on posters, print media, the radio, or internet posts? How did the advance sale of tickets go? Do we have any insights from comparable events in other cities? Is there any concrete knowledge on who will come and by which route? How is the weather going to be one of the day of the event? The most important questions, however, needs to be, is the place or area of the venue compatible with the expected number of participants? The security of the whole event stands and falls with the answer to this question. In the end, it is about not getting surprised and at worst getting literally overrun on the day of the event. Ladies and gentlemen, I will now speak about an issue that I find very important, the consumption of alcohol during events. As far as I know, the starting position is very different in your country. Yet allow me to say a few sentences of this. By implementing suited measures, we aim to prevent alcohol-related disorder, like, for example, fights, damages to property, and rioting that affects uninvolved people during events. We have a variety of possibilities here. They go from special regulations on serving spirits over checks of compliance with legal relations for the protection of minors to issuing general orders that forbid carrying and consuming alcohol in definite areas. Our experience have shown that issuing a general order can elevate the situation substantially. Alcohol-related excesses have been nearly absent. We do not record any more problems with broken bottles. This illustrates what positive effects the construction of cooperation between security authority and police can have on the security situation during events. The external factors, weather and parallel events, are not in the responsibility of the organizer. The responsibility security authority should, however, reflect on whether it is possible to safely carry you another event of the same day in view of the effects of an event on traffic, the visitors, and the vicinity. Equally important is, however, we mutually influence each other. The visitors of a classical concert will likely have little understanding for loudly roaring football fans, the same way as people opposing each other politically or socially will not demonstrate entirely peaceful side by side. One world imagine that looking at the weather forecasts, you would make the organizers plan reasonably. yet we have experienced time and again that either due to a lacking alternative date and or the pursuit of economic gains, they still carry out an event despite all warnings by the meteorological services. As a result, in 2014, we had several unnecessary and dangerous situations that absolutely could have ended much worse. For example, during a Holy Cholera festival, which involved visitors throwing powder at each other on cue and dancing, the events had to be broken up because of an approaching storm. Nearly all guests then wanted to take the subway at the same time to go home. The only problem was that due to the rain, the cholera was sticking on the visitors and sold the trains. For this reason, the Munich Transport Company refused the transport and closed the subway station. This caused an immense pressure of the persons at the gates leading down to the station as the persons at the back were pushing on forwards. These situations could have been prevented by postponing or canceling the event early on. If several of the disturbances I mentioned come together, this results in a dangerous situation very quickly, the dimension of which cannot be foreseen and possibly lead to a great number of injured persons or even fatalities. When at an event the point of overcrowding has been reached on small things, that is on one additional triggering moment, can create a panic, which is then followed by uncontrollable mass phenomena. Hence, apart from a professional security surveillance carrying out entry checks and as such controlling the number of visitors, a control concept for streams of visitors is indispensable. Here are, by way of example, some other factors that on their very own can lead to an emergency: hazard on disaster situation, attacks, technical breakdowns, or storm. It might not only be their own direct effects, but also an indirect effect by way of the relations of the unaffected visitors that can lead to further victims as a consequence of panic and irrational behavior in crowds. Unfortunately, reality tells us time and again that these scenarios are not only produced by the imagination of planning groups and crisis managers. The tragic disaster at an open-air music event in Duisburg in the North Rhine-Westphalia in 2010, during which 21 people died and more than 500 persons were injured, remains with us a painful memory in Germany. Mistakes during the preparation of the event make it clear that in our pursuit of the highest possible safety and the defense of dangers, we must never rest on and be satisfied with what we had achieved. The cooperation with all other security authorities needs to be developed continuously. And we must in particular not forget the people behind the tragedies, family and friends of the victims, but we constantly have to keep them in mind as urgent witnesses for further optimizing security of major events. Ladies and gentlemen, a good preparation is half the operation. That is why, for me, the preparation for the next operation always already starts with a construction follow-up work of the finalized operation. We use the insights that we gain from an analysis from open to criticism in combination with the already existent operational experience in order to be even better prepared for possible scenarios during the next operation. It is my special concern to campaign for a positive mistake culture today, too, that is not characterized by the participant blaming each other during discussions, but rather working together to solve problems the best way possible, together with all parties involved. This is the only way to guarantee more safety for the visitors. An important part of planning on operations is preparing a security concept. The security concept for an event or venue always needs to be prepared by the respective organizer or operator. With the security concept, the organizer or operator is supposed to give thought in the run-up to the event to possible event-related risk and scenarios they could possibly face. This is to contribute to the corresponding implementation in case of a crisis and to all parties involved knowing the necessary steps. The aim of a security concept is in particular to define the responsibilities, name responsibility persons, explain scenarios, determine the rules of conduct and communication channels, and to plan the deployment of on staff. Legal norms in Germany stipulate that for the operator of an assembly venue with capacities for more than 5,000 visitors, it is mandatory to prepare a security concept, establish a security service, and to reach an agreement with the authorities responsible for safety and order, especially the police, the fire brigade, and the emergency medical services. If it's the duty of the security authorities to see to a maximum in safety for the visitors of events independently of and irrespective of economic aspects. What is more, events on public streets or places require a licensed person to the traffic code. All security concepts, no matter if legally mandatory or otherwise demanded by the security authorities, need to be prepared, especially in accordance with the police, the fire brigade, and the event and assembly office. The organizer should submit the final mutually agreed version of the security concept to the authorities at the latest 14 days before the event. After that only, additionally, changes may be made. Ladies and gentlemen, finally, I would like to present to you the task and measures of the Bavarian Police during major events. I will make my explanations on aspects of operational tactics transparent using the example of the Munich Oktoberfest. By protecting the basic rights, the police also guarantees conflicts to be settled within the boundaries drawn by law and justice. The police has to guarantee public safety or order primarily by prevention measures. Infringements are to be prevented within the scope of legal guidelines and, if necessary, to be pursued consistently. In individual cases, a security framework prepared in the run-up to the event to fend off threats or disturbances by participants and no participants determines the deployment of police staff. For this purpose, we assess the aforementioned factors inherent in the event as well as the external factors and incorporate this in the planning and decision-making process. The experiences of the previous years and a team working well together, be it the police or the involved organizations with security duties, have produced a common standard of safety at the Munich Oktoberfest that makes me personally proud too. As early as weeks beforehand, we begin with talks, written notifications to the press, and in the meantime, an offensive public relations work in social networks too. The goal is to inform and prepare the public with regard to necessary measures, the inevitable distracts, and the possible obstructions. A friendly and communicative appearance of the fairground itself combined with a strong police presence granted by our operation forces are closed units, often preventing safety disturbances before they start to develop. Deploying foreign colleagues has also proven itself a successful means to help many foreign guests in a simply and uncomplicated way. The dimensions of the measures in the run-up to the event and determined by the probability of a disturbance and the anticipated extent of damage in this context, operation forces can be specifically prepared for major occasions by the exercise situations, if necessary, together with other authorities. Holding meetings and carrying out on-site inspections, especially relating to access authorities, as well as agreements on the cooperation with persons responsible and how they can be reached. Facilitate the cooperation between the people affected and the police, the fire brigade, and the emergency medical services in case of all emergency. After the fairground and the superstructure have been checked and approved on site and as standard shortly before the beginning of the major event, the representatives of all security authorities, the organizer and the head of the security service participate in a meeting that is part of the security concept and called situation. During major events of the Theresienwiese, the security authorities have at their disposal the so-called service center. Suited to the special requirements of operation, the Oktoberfest, it was planned and built in 2004. Besides the police staff of the medical service and fire brigade are present in one building in the service center. What is more, contact persons of the Department for Public Order Munich and other city departments are always on site. This way, agreements can be made bilaterally and without any delay. During general duty, you can provide help quicker, and in case of emergency, you win valuable time. In cases of major hazard, emergency, or disaster situations, the necessary police measures are regulated by a special operation concept. This is communicated. This is communicated to all forces with the written mission or and in the operational briefing. We determine and subdivide in detail the measures in chronological phases after the occurrence of an emergency. All that point is no longer possible to cope with such a situation only by calling up forces as well as command and control. Devices and operational equipment from the daily duty individual forces supported by the corresponding operations control center first adopt the necessary immediate measures within the framework of a basis BAO. In case of an emergency, the executive staff of the police taking over the mission and then centrally steers the police forces. So commanding officer himself is regularly at the place of the event and leads the mission on site. He remains in contact with the head of the executive staff, who himself has an overview over the whole mission. During ad hoc situations requiring a great number of forces, the coordination of the forces plays a pivotal role in order to ease the responsive operational commands burden. A gathering point of police forces is to be set up or already taken into consideration during the planning phase of an event, if possible. Analogously to the gathering point of police forces, a fire brigade sets up staging area. In case of a disaster, the disaster management agency takes over the operational command and is also authorized to issue directive to the police. It also needs to establish the executive task force disaster management, which exercises the command function. In Munich's executive task force, disaster management is again subdivided into the staff for extraordinary incidents as well as a hazard defense control. It appoints a local commander of the fire brigade to perform its task at the place of emergency. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope I was able to show you with my speech with problems we as security authorities can face during major events. I would like to thank you for the opportunity to present to you the conceptual targets of the police headquarters Munich on this. I wish you only the best for the realization and handling of your major events and especially the necessary energy for the intense preparations. Thank you very much for your attention.